Excellencies, dear Pedro Sánchez, President of the Government of Spain, Deputy Secretary General Amina Mohamed, dear Alicia Bárcena, Executive Secretary of ECLAC, and all distinguished friends who accompany us today. The Secretary General called us for action. And action is what FACE is all about. It's about facing what is happening today in the world. An unprecedented number of 102 countries have requested emergency financing from the IMF and to address COVID-19 on the shock of what has happened in our economies. The Secretary General gathered a group leading by Prime Minister of Canada, Justin Trudeau, and Prime Minister of Jamaica, Andrew Holmes, to start working on initiatives to address this. So Costa Rica became part of this group, and we are presenting FACE, the fund to alleviate COVID economics, as a concrete option to address this. That's why it has to be ambitious. That is why it has to be innovative, because the situation, frankly, it's very difficult across the globe. A global problem requires a global solution, and FACE is a global solution. I will first go directly and cut the chase directly to what the proposal is about, and then I'm saying why it's so urgent for us to advocate for this solution and this kind of solution and discuss about it and recruit all the support around the globe from emerging economies, from poor and rich countries as well, to make such an ambitious initiative true. What is it that we are proposing? We are proposing to create a fund with many resources. That is to say, we're going to ask and request, recruit the countries that represent 80% of global GDP to contribute with the amount of approximately the equivalent of their 0.7 GDP to fund this. This is going to be about $500 billion to build up this fund. But this fund will represent for the rest of the countries, the emerging economies and the poor economies, the equivalent of 3% of their GDP. That is to address the problems caused by COVID-19. And this 3% is to beneficiate those countries in need. The FACE funds will be destined to mitigate the economic impact on the countries, on their productive sectors, and on households caused by the economic crisis, and to revive economies and to build back better, but making it a reality. Also to recover once the pandemic is overcome. This is critical to reach the SDGs and the 2030 agenda. FACE will be lent to countries with concessional and solidary terms. We are proposing loans at 50 years term with 5 years of grace period and a rate of 0% interest rates or fixed at current prevailing rates, which are close to zero. This is not a grant, it is a loan that will be repaid in full. However, we propose these terms, which are commensurate with the extraordinary circumstances which go beyond financial policies. The beneficiary countries, with the advice of the financial institutions or regional economic commissions, will establish an accounting system and a registry of statistics to identify the fiscal cost of the pandemic, both the direct cost of dealing with it and the derived from its economic consequences and the policies. This will contribute to ascertaining an accurate amount of each loan by needs and vulnerability, rather than generalized classification like income per capita. As their contribution in these dire circumstances, we are requesting that financial organizations will not charge for the intermediation and administration of FACE resources. And this is an important point. FACE is not creating new bureaucracy or new institutions. FACE is about capitalizing and providing international finance institutions with this capital, with these conditions to help emerging economies and to help poor countries. FACE will be lent without fiscal, monetary, or structural conditionalities. These are already being tackled by the standard lending facilities of IMF or World Bank, but with requirements of good governments and steady fight against corruption from countries. This is also important, and I want to underline this. IMF and World Bank and other financial institutions are doing an extraordinary work today. As I mentioned, more than 102 countries have gone already to the IMF in this situation. But more effort is required, and we need to go beyond that. And that is what FACE is all about. We want and we need to go beyond current efforts. The reimbursement of FACE resources will be fully aligned with the fulfillment of the 2030 Agenda and the SDGs, building resilience and achieving the targets of multilateral environmental agreements, such as countries' national determined contributions to accelerate progress towards sustainable development in the decade of action. Lastly, international financial institutions will maintain the assessments and dialogues on the macroeconomical and structural conditions on each country, which prevailed prior to the crisis caused by the pandemic, to preserve fiscal and monetary stability as well as sustainability. So those are the main points of what FACE is all about. But now I want to go to the justification of FACE. As I mentioned, a global problem requires a global solution. The pandemic is increasing inequality, not only within the countries, but a global inequality. As we have seen, the recovery, even now, it's uneven. Those economies that have the fiscal space and the resources, as we have seen in China, in the United States, and in the case of Europe, have gathered the packages and the measures to protect their growth and their economies. I underline the example of Europe preserving not only their economies, but building to have a greener rebirth after the crisis. But if the developing world, if the emerging economies and the poor economies do not have access to this kind of resources, the rebound is going to be very uneven. And this is not only going to impact the world economy. This is going to impact things such as migrations, for example, political and democratic stability within our countries, given the difficult situations. This is going to impact international trade if we don't act now. Even the rich countries are going to see a decrease on their trade terms with emerging and poor economies, given that increase of unemployment, poverty, and that the reduction of our growth is going to make us buy less and trade less with the richer economies. This is also going to harm the developed world. Security is also going to be an issue. In emerging and poor countries, situations like drug trafficking, human trafficking, and many other illicits might find their way in this complex situation. And also, if the situation is so difficult to achieve the goals of the 2030 agenda, and particularly the goals on climate change and the climate crisis, is going to be more difficult. Today is the kind of occasion in which solidarity and altruism, doing what's correct, doing the best for the whole of the world, is also aligned with the self-interest of all. There's not going to be individual or national welfare or well-being across the globe if we don't have regional or global solutions and well-being across the globe. That's what FACE is all about. I want to thank all the team that has worked to put this together, also the leadership of Secretary General Guterres, of Deputy Secretary General Amina Mohamed, of Prime Minister Trudeau, and of Prime Minister Holmes leading this team. And Costa Rica is committed not only to be part of the discussion, but to put forward a concrete solution to be discussed, for which we are very willing to advocate and to make it happen. And now what we call upon other world leaders, all from the academia and other stakeholders in public and private sector, is to build upon this proposal, but particularly to take action and make it happen.